Okay, so we've worked out the dwarf walls, or the bricks we need for the dwarf wall. We've worked out the bricks we need for the engaged piers. The next thing we need to know is the bricks that we need for the isolated piers, and they are the ones that are going to sit out in the middle here and support the bearers at their required span distance. So really, it's just a matter of lining up the intersections of our engaged piers. If you laid our engaged piers out right, all we should have to do is wherever these lines intersect, we need an engaged piers, because these are at our maximum bearer spacing and these are at our maximum bearer spacing. So wherever they intersect, we need an isolated pier. So again, a bearer is going to run in that direction, not really going to be a big factor for this particular video. But we need a isolated pier there on that line, isolated pier on that line, so that means our bearer is going to run down, sit on top of all of those. There will be another one sit on top of that line of engaged piers there, and we'll have another one run down this side as well. We're going to need one there to pick up that bearer, and one there to pick up that bearer, and then we'll have a bearer running down here. So that's all the isolated piers that we need, 5 of them. So then, to work out how many bricks there are, we know there's 5 piers. We know from the previous video that there are, these piers are 6 bricks high, or 6 courses high. But you'll notice that there's 2 bricks per course, so we need to double the original number. So 5 piers, 6 courses high, 2 bricks per course gives us 60 bricks for our engaged piers. Sorry, our isolated piers. 60 bricks for our isolated piers. So we can take that 60, add that to the total for our engaged piers, add that to the total for our dwarf wall, work out our waste, and that will give us the total amount of bricks for our subfloor system.